Hi, I'm Marion, I'm 56 and I'm a classroom assistant. My day begins when my alarm goes off at 7 a.m. I get up, go to the toilet, brush my teeth, I then do a bit of exercise, some yoga. By that time my husband is home from his night shift and he started making the breakfast. I go downstairs and it's usually porridge for breakfast. I put some nuts and seeds in my porridge. I have a vitamin drink and I take my vitamins and go and sit and have my porridge with my husband, just have a chat, and that's it. He's off to his bed. I go up the stairs, have my shower and get ready for work. If there's a bit of time, I maybe do a bit of tidying up or a quick bit of ironing. I leave the house at 8:45. The school that I work in is really local. It's only 3 minutes away from my house. So I go down and I stand at the school gate every morning and I welcome the children into the school. The bell goes at 9 a.m. and we all head into the school. Once we're organised, my first job is to take a small group of children and I work with a number box. This supports the children in their maths learning. Then about 9:30, I'll go into a class, maybe work with a larger group of children, maybe with their language work, do their phonemes, their magnetic boards, listen to them read, support them in the class situation. At 10:15, I then go for my tea break. That lasts 15 minutes. At 10:30, the bell goes, and that's playtime. So I accompany the children out into the playground, do our playground duty for 15 minutes. And then the bell goes again at 10:45. I then go to my next class. I can be all over the school. I'm the only classroom assistant that's left in the school now. So the next class I could be in the class with the teacher, supporting various groups. If it's a writing lesson, it could be supporting with their spelling, just ideas. If it's narrative writing, or it could be descriptive writing. And that will last up until 12:15, and the bell goes for lunchtime. Again, I'm out at the playground supporting the children. Like to maybe play hide and seek, skipping ropes. I deal with any injuries in the first instance. And then the bell goes again at 1 p.m. and that's lunchtime over. The children head back in and I just come home from my lunch every day. Usually have like oat cakes and hummus or cheese, cup of green tea, like my green tea. And then I get 45 minutes for my lunch and then that's me back down to school. In the afternoon, I'm timetabled to a different class. It could be maths work again, it could be language, or it could be we have a kitchen area in the school. So it could be cooking or baking. I support the children doing that as well. So the bell goes at 3 o'clock and that is my working day over. I get tidied up and I come up the road. If it's a nice day, myself and my husband might go out for a walk, might go and visit friends or go out for a coffee. And we have our dinner reasonably early now, say about 4:30, 5 p.m. as my husband leaves for his work just after 6 p.m. Once he's gone to his work, while we're having our tea, there's a couple of programmes I like to watch on the TV, and that's Flog It and Pointless. So watch that, then he goes off to his work. Maybe do a bit of tidying up, a bit of housework. I like to go to Keep Fit class, maybe meet up with friends, and I like to watch these box sets. At the moment, myself and my son are watching The American Office, so that's quite funny. And then have a cup of tea, maybe around about 10 o'clock. My husband gives me a phone once he's reached his destination, just to let me know that everything was okay and he got there okay. And then I try to be in my bed for 11 p.m. and that's my day.